Hi everyone, it's Dita and welcome to our channel. How are you? I hope that you are well and stay at home right now. Well, in this video, I'd like to tell you about something. I think you can already guess it from the title of this video. So, are you curious about that? Make sure to keep on watching. Well, as a teacher, the thing that must be well prepared before conducting the class beside lesson plan is a method. There are several methods in language teaching. In this video, I will explain to you a comparison between grammar translation method or GTM and direct method. But before going to the comparison between them, first I will tell you what GTM and direct method are. Number one, what is GTM? GTM is a method that based on the target of grammatical competence that focuses on the grammar as a basic of a language it is. Number two, what is direct method? According to Freeman, the direct method is a radical change from grammar translation method by the use of the target language as a means of instructions and communication in the language classroom and by the avoidance of the use of the first language and translations as a technique. In direct method, no translations is allowed. Next, let's go to the comparison between them. Number one, the goal. The first and foremost difference between the grammar translation method and direct method is the goals of the teachers using them. In GTM, the teacher's purpose is to help student to read and understanding literature that written in the target language. While in direct method, the teacher's purpose is to help the students to learn how to communicate in the target language. Number two, the process. In GTM, students are taught to translate from one language to another. While in direct method, students are trained to speak a lot. Number three, the language used. In GTM, classes are taught in the mother tongue with a little active use of the target language. While in direct method, class instructions is conducted exclusively in the target language. Number four, grammar. In GTM, grammar is taught deductively. It is focused on grammar rules and their application. The students are asked to memorize the rules. While in direct method, the teacher provides the knowledge in grammar inductively through speak. Number five, vocabulary. In GTM, the vocabulary is learned from the direct translation of DL1. The students learn vocabulary when they are translating. They are asked to memorize the native language equivalents for the target language vocabulary words in the form of list. While in direct method, the vocabulary is learned through practice every day. Number six, teacher's attitude. In GTM, the role of the teacher is not very active because they just limit their work to translate for the students. While in direct method, the role of the teacher is very important. They ask the students constantly, encourage them to participate in class and correct their mistakes immediately. Number seven, students' role. In GTM, the accuracy from the students is expected, and they have to practice with translation. While in direct method, the students are very active. Their oral communication skills are emphasized and they have to speak a lot. Number eight, skills to be improved. In GTM, primary skills to be improved are reading and writing. While in direct method, oral communication skills were built up in a carefully grade. And the last one is the output. GTM students will be perfect grammarians and translators, while direct method students will be good communicators, especially in oral situations. So, in short, I can rightly say that both methods have advantages and disadvantages. It's up to you as a teacher to choose or combine the methods according to your teaching situation, so that your students will get the most benefit. So, that's all about my video today. If you guys enjoying this video, don't forget to click the thumbs up, make sure to subscribe this channel, and turn the notification on, because I can't wait to see you again in the next video. See you!